Hello students, in this video we will try to understand the next concept of the magnetic effect of electric current is the force acting on current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. अब तक हमने क्या देखा कि हमने देखा magnetic field, उसके properties देखे, उसके magnetic field lines देखे हमने, उसके बाद में मैंने कुछ activities बताए आपको, हमने स्टेट कंडक्टर देखा, हमने सर्कुलर लूप देखा, वहाँ पर हमने बात की किसकी, राइट हैंड थंब रूल की, वहाँ पर दो रूल देखे, अगर एक क्लोज लूप वायर है तो उसका टॉप सरफेस कैसे दिखाई देगा, उसका लोअर सरफेस कैसे दिखाएगा, उसके रूल क्या है, उसके ट्रिक्स क्या है, मैंने सब आपको बताया था. नाउ इन दैट केस इज इट पॉसिबल दैट इफ एनी करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर इज प्लेस्ड इन एन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विल इट experience of force, because this is what the phenomena which has changed many things we'll talk about later on. Clear? Is it possible? Because many of the appliances, many of the devices, obviously they depend upon this phenomena. So how does this device and the instruments or the appliances works? To understand that, first of all, we will need to be understand this, whether it is possible or not. Any conductor is placed in an external magnetic field, will it exert a force or not? If it is exert, how the force is going to be exert and how to calculate the direction of that force, there we need to be discussed. To discuss that, let us suppose this is one setup I have made here. This is the stand. Clear? On that stand, there are two hooks are there, and between these two hooks, this is the one hook and rubber hooks, between these two hooks, I have taken one copper wire, and that copper wire is placed like that. And there is one magnet is taken, that is called as the horseshoe magnet, isn't it? This is what the horseshoe magnet, and this is what the copper wire is connected. Hope you understood the setup of this diagram. Clear? So this is the horseshoe magnet, north pole, south pole, and the copper wire is connected. Clear? And this copper wire, then it is connected to the battery, as you can able to take a look. Okay, so that the current will start flowing through the copper wire, and they will observe whether on that copper wire the force is going to be exerted or not. Now, where is the external magnetic field? This external magnetic field is going to be provided by this magnet. Clear? Now, north to south, this is what the direction of the magnetic field. Clear? Now, there is another stand, the stand is taken to just hold the magnet. Clear? And this is what the exact setup. Now, let us find it out whether it is going to be happen or not. Now, you want to believe that what happens exactly when the current is passed through that copper wire, that is from the direction of the current is from this direction. Let us suppose this point is called as the X point and this point is called as the Y point. Clear? Now, through that copper wire, the current is allowed to pass. Initially, the current is passing through the X to Y. This is what the direction of the electric current. Clear? So, the current is flowing from X to Y through that copper wire, and this copper wire which is placed in the external magnetic field. So it was observed that this copper wire is deflected to that position. This is what the point it is called as the B. Clear? So this B point indicates that this copper wire gets exerted to which direction? In the B direction. This is what the direction of, this is what the what it is to be called as the coil or the copper wire exerts a force. Copper wire experience a force due to because of where? Because of the current passing through that as well as the electric current. Clear? Similarly, when the direction of the current gets reverses, when this terminal circuit reverses, minus to this and plus to this, the current starts flowing in that direction. From where to where? Y to X. This is what. Clear? When the current is flowing from the Y to X, then it was observed that the direction of force is what? In the opposite direction as that of earlier. Clear? तो ये जो कॉपर वायर है ये किस डायरेक्शन में चला गया, इन विच डायरेक्शन दिस कॉपर वायर वाज एक्सपीरियंस्ड अ फोर्स, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ व्हाट, सी. क्लियर? सो दिस इज द हियर इज द व्हाट वी कैन से द पोजीशन ऑफ द वायर, विच मींस दैट व्हेन वी चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, ऑब्वियसली व्हाट विल हैपन, द फोर्स, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स इज ऑल्सो गेट रिवर्स. क्लियर? बट इज इट पॉसिबल टू चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड? इट बिकम्स वेरी फिजिकली. Clear? We need to change the position of the magnet physically. So it becomes very difficult task. So instead of just changing the position of the magnet, by changing the direction of the magnetic field, sorry, by changing the direction of the electric current, obviously we can change the direction of the force. This is what exactly it is to be called as. And hence from this experiment it was observed that wire will experience a force. Clear? So what should we write it on here? Wire, the wire experiences force. Clear? And also the direction of force gets reversed or changes when direction of current changes. This is what a very simple thing. Clear? When the direction of the electric current gets changed, then the direction of the force gets what? Reverse, and it changes. This is what the thing. It becomes opposite, exactly. पहले वो इधर आया था, जैसे हमने direction of current change किया, so this copper wire goes to that direction. Clear? This is a very simple phenomenon. But now thing is that, how do we can calculate the direction of force? How we can calculate the direction of force? This is a major important thing. And hence, to find it out the direction of force, we have one rule, and that rule is given by what? Fleming's. That is what the reason, that rule is called as what? Fleming's left hand rule. Which rule? Fleming's left hand rule. Dear student, this rule is very, very important. This rule is used to find it out the direction of force. आपने एक सुना भी होगा क्या FBI? What is the FBI? F is the force, B is what? Magnetic field, I is what? The current. This is what? So this rule works on one concept that is called with the FBI. Clear? So where F is what? F is the force, B is the magnetic field, B is what? Magnetic field, I is what? Current. I is what? Current. Now it is very simple, as you know that. But what this rule states that? This rule is called as the Fleming's left hand rule. What is the Fleming's left hand rule? It states that thumb, this is what, the outstretch your left hand, this, the thumb indicate the direction of the force. Middle finger indicate the direction of magnetic field. Forefinger indicate the direction of magnetic field. And this middle finger indicate the direction of what? Electric current. I repeat what I'm saying. According to the Fleming's left hand rule, what I'm telling you is that Fleming's left hand rule. This Fleming's left hand rule is what? FBI. What is the F? F is the force, B is the magnetic field, and I is what? The electric current. So what this rule states? Clear? Hold your left hand rule. Outstretch your thumb. Thumb indicates the direction of the force. Index finger indicate the direction of magnetic field. And the middle finger indicate the direction of what? Electric current. This is what. And all, you can observe this diagram. Clear? This is what the direction of magnetic field, direction of current. Are they perpendicular? Yes. Force and magnetic field, perpendicular or not? Yes. Force and the current, perpendicular or not? Yes. Which means that all there has to be what? Perpendicular direction to get the maximum force. Clear? To get the maximum force on that copper wire, their arrangement should be what? Perpendicular to each other. Force must be perpendicular to magnetic field. Force must be perpendicular to what? Electric current. To get the maximum force. This is what the case. So what he stated? Now he stated that thumb, outstretched thumb, indicate the direction of what? Force. Clear? Then index finger, indicate the direction of what? Magnetic field. Clear? And current, indicate the direction of what? That is the middle finger, indicate the direction of what? Current. Indicate the direction of what? Current. And all they are perpendicular to each other. FBI. F is the force, B is the magnetic field, and I is what? The current. Clear? So then thumb indicate the force, index finger indicate the magnetic field, and the middle fingers indicate the current. This is what? Hold this position. This is your left hand. Hold your left hand. Outstretch the thumb, indicate the direction of the force. Index finger indicate the direction of the magnetic field, and the middle finger indicate the direction of current. You can observe. These two are perpendicular. Clear? These two are perpendicular.
Getting what I'm saying, sir? And this two are also what? Perpendicular. That is what the reason this is very, very important. And hence, we can show this diagrammatically also. That if suppose the force is in that direction, magnetic field is in that direction. Clear? Force is in that direction. And magnetic field is in that direction. Then this will be the direction of what? Electric current. Actually perpendicular, agar aapko dikhana hai. So it is better use this left hand rule. Clear? They both are perpendicular. They are perpendicular. They are also perpendicular. Which means that to get the maximum force, they must be perpendicular to each other. That is what it is called in the Fleming's left hand rule. Clear? Now, the Fleming's left hand rule can be some of the examples we need to be. So, what is the example? Let us suppose. What is that? This is what the direction of magnetic field. This is the direction of magnetic field. And this is what the direction of current. Clear? This is the direction of current. What is the direction of force now? Use your Fleming's left hand rule. How to use the Fleming's left hand rule? Come on. First, point your finger in the direction of current. Clear? So, where is the current? Current is in the downward direction. So, this is the current is in the downward direction. Correct? Now, the next one, magnetic field. Where is your magnetic field? Magnetic field is in the direction. Clear? So, this is what the direction of magnetic field. This is what the direction of current. Index finger gives the direction of magnetic field. Middle finger gives the direction of the electric current. Now, just outstretch the thumb. बस थंब को बाहर निकालो, क्या मिलेगा आपको? डायरेक्शन ऑफ किसका? फोर्स का. मतलब कि वो कंडक्टर और वायर जो भी होगा या रॉड होगा वो किस डायरेक्शन में जाएगा. दिस इज व्हाट. सो देन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स विल बी इन दैट डायरेक्शन. हाउ सिंपल इट इज. क्लियर? नाउ जस्ट दिस इज वन एग्जांपल. नाउ यू कैन डू द सेकंड एग्जांपल. रिवर्स इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट. क्लियर? नाउ लेट अस सपोज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. द करंट इज इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन द डायरेक्शन. दिस इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड डायरेक्शन. Clear? Where will be the, what will be the direction of the force? The direction of the force is here. You can see, when you change the direction of the current, the direction of force gets reversed. It is exactly opposite to that earlier. That is how it is important, importance of that Fleming's left hand rule we are having. Clear, Babu? Another example also we can do. What is another example? Let us suppose, electron is moving in that direction. Electron is moving in that direction. Magnetic field is in that direction. So, what is the direction of what? Force. What is the direction of force? Clear? If the electron is moving in that direction, so what should be the direction of current? Obviously, it is opposite to the flow of electron. Conventionally, we have electric current. Clear? So, the direction of magnetic field must be opposite to that. So, then the current is flowing in which direction? The current is in what? In that direction. Clear? So then easily we can understand this is the Fleming left hand rule. So current is what? In the direction. This is the direction of the current. Clear? Observe the example. Direction of the current. Where is the magnetic field? In the downward direction. So this is the direction of magnetic field. Hope it is very much visible to you. Clear? So this is the direction of what? Current. This is the direction of magnetic field. What is the direction of what? Force. Force will be in that direction. Clear? It becomes very difficult, but hope you are understanding. So this is the direction of what? Current, direction of magnetic field, direction of what? Force. So that is what this Fleming's left hand rule is what? It's very, very important. Clear? And that is what there is one device called the electric motor which works on what? This concept. Clear? So this Fleming's left hand rule is very much useful while learning the concept of what it is to be called the electric motor. Hope it is very much clear to you all.